Shirley, I'm hearing consistently from parents, online learning was difficult and often disappointing.
It was horrible. Nobody knew what they were doing.
In West County, Lorraine Telavas says her grandkids fell behind in the spring.
It got a little bit better towards the end. I think if they could do more in person, maybe send the teachers to the classroom and have all the kids stay at home and go through room or something like that and do it, I think I'd be okay. But me having to guide them makes me nervous. I'm not a teacher.
That's echoed by North County's Tequila Griffin.
So I didn't sign up to be a teacher, and so now it's harder because now I have to have a new routine of sitting down, trying to get them to understand, you know, online, just reading, you know, the information.
That's exactly what many districts are doing, moving from what's called asynchronous learning, which means learning online at your own time with limited teacher-student interaction, to synchronous learning, which is online education that happens in real time.
And we heard from parents that that's something that their students really need to make sure that they stay engaged and continue to do their work.
Bill Bass is Parkway's innovation coordinator. His district is striving for a little bit of both.
Kids are going to engage not just with content, but with each other and with their teacher.
They're implementing new online learning management systems like Google Classroom, Canvas, and Schoology. They look like social media sites to help students organize and communicate.
This is what Schoology looks like inside of our classes. And you can see going through here that things are now organized in folders.
Hancock Place School District in South County had already for years supplied every student with a computer, but they still had the challenge of getting students connected to the school from home.
Our kids missed their teachers. Our kids missed their school families. And so we needed a place for them to safely get on, be able to see their friends, and be able to get the content that they needed, and be able to turn in their work.
They found many families did not have Wi-Fi.
Getting parents to admit that they need that help is also sometimes a little hard.
In some cases, it took personal visits from school counselors like Sherry Rishbeater.
We were getting reports from teachers left and right saying they were concerned about students not responding to phone calls, not getting on their computers.
Through a grant from Step Up St. Louis to purchase Wi-Fi hotspots, Hancock Place says it believes it will have 100% of families able to connect. Mary Catherine Jones says a personal visit not only helped her with a Wi-Fi hotspot, but also helped get her children on track.
They kept the social distance, but still there, the kids could come out on the porch, we could all see somebody. It was somebody from school. Somebody that, not that I'm not an authority figure, but like I said, I'm mom. Kids fight mom. But they actually had somebody from school tell them they had to do this. It was schoolwork. Your future depends on it. And that was all it took.
Open up the Fox 2 app where you will find all of the reports I've put together today, including some reports I put together exclusively for online viewing. If you go to Fox 2 now and open up the coronavirus tab at the top, then click on COVID and the classroom, you'll see some of those exclusive web reports, including what the flu season could bring as an unexpected challenge, what a pediatrician says about that, and how mental health professionals are reaching kids even in a time when many are not in the classroom. Live in St. Louis County, Chris Hayes, Fox 2 News.